here.
What's up, everybody? It's your favorite one-dimensional characters turn three favorite nerd, and today we are looking at the Hot Toys Punisher from Daredevil Season 2. I'm not a big Punisher fan, but I am a big Punisher Netflix fan. I think that this dude added a lot of depth to this character that's just not there in the comics. I feel like in the comics it's just a little too simple, the point-and-shoot kind of mentality, which is fine, and I get it, but it loses its charm on me relatively quickly. That being said, I found the series to be very engaging and was very satisfied by it, so yeah, I'm a fan. I've fallen down the Hot Toys rabbit hole. That's a story for another time. But today we're going to talk about this guy. Relatively new, so I hope it gets some people's attention. That being said, let's start with accessories. Let's switch it up today a taste. We'll start with a display base. Got the street there, which looks great. It's textured, which is also cool. My camera spinning, which is not cool. And then we have this bit that just clips in, has the Daredevil thing, has a little protective sheet over top of it. And then we have the kind of clip that goes into the stand that we've become accustomed to with the Hot Toys figures. Just snaps in, then you use these prongs to kind of grab underneath the crotch, so to speak. We get some hands. Two supporting hands, slash relaxed hands, slash posing hands. You can make them use the force. Left and right, two trigger finger hands, left and right. They are slightly different, and just it seems as though, anyway, in terms of like the relaxed grip of the fingers, it seems like this one is a little bit tighter than this one, so you might have different luck with different guns, etc. Then we have two knife holding hands, and then we have two fist hands, and then he comes with two relaxed hands in the opening footage. And what good is a Punisher without an arsenal? He comes with this knife, black blade, silver paint along the blade itself, and then like a almost wooden brown paint added there to the grip, which is a nice brown, and it really does give that illusion. And then it comes with a little holster for it, so to speak, and you can put it in there, and then it has this little, I guess, yeah, magnetic clasp to hold it down. All the little buttons and stuff on there, and this is that faux leathery material. It comes with a pistol, a revolver. You can actually rotate out the revolver chamber. You can see it's fully loaded, no big deal. And you can put it back, and I wonder, no, you can't cock the hammer back. But other than that, it's pretty cool. Sculpt is good, the trigger's painted, this the hammer's painted, and then I don't think anything else is done to it outside of the bullets being painted inside of the chamber, the revolver there. Then we start getting to the higher powered stuff. This has a bolt action mechanism here, so you can lift it up and load it back. Boom, boom. That's pretty cool. And then the stock actually collapses, and the magazine is removable, and inside the bullets are all painted and such, so that's cool. And the sculpt is beautiful. You can extend this, and it'll hold with tension kind of where you would want it. And, you know, just a couple of different bells and whistles and such, but it's really well done, really well painted. You know my feeling on Hot Toys accessories, they tend to just hit home runs every chance they get, and this is no exception. Lastly, when you need that a little bit of assurance that you're going to kill everybody in the room, he comes with a minigun. We got thin little plastic kind of tubings here. Be careful, that makes me very nervous, but, you know, They're trusting you to be an adult, and I'm trying to trust myself. So overall, it's just black plastic. It looks like there might be some, yeah, there's some silver dry brushing in some areas, but for the most part, it's just a flat black, but I do think it works. And then we have the red kind of Oh Mama button right there. And then we have the ammunition that I'm trying to figure out what's the front and back of this unit. I'm not sure if it matters, but this just plugs into the side here. And then you have this hole, and it's a lot, so he can, you know, rest over one hand, etc., while he's holding the other one, and that's pretty cool. And absolutely no problem holding any of those. Then he also comes with replacement wrist pegs and replacement sequins, for lack of a better term. A Daredevil helmet, strictly meant for posing. You can't, like, put it on top of a figure. At least they advise you not to. We got some red translucent plastic for the eyes. It looks really good. Some really dark translucent in there. It gives it that glassy look to it. And then we have the black, and then the burgundy is the base color, painted and sculpted to the nines. And his black leather trench coat. It's got the faux leather on the outside, the kind of satiny inside. And you have a wire frame down here in the bottom to kind of help pose it. And it would be nice, it's not there. It'd be nice if they put it in the collar as well, I think. And there he is with his coat on. I'll show it a little bit more in final thoughts, but just so you know, the articulation is gonna be a little bit more hindered, but not really a whole lot. You can still pretty much get everything you can out of it in terms of what's already there. This was actually a little bit more challenging to find a relevant picture because he goes through such little minor alterations throughout the series and such, but I think they've pretty much got it. I think that his earlobe is maybe a bit intense. Adam pointed that out to me, and ever since he did, I just can't unsee it. But I think they've got it. I think they've got the facial structure. I think they've got, like, the eyes, especially the mouth, nose, chin. I think it all looks the part. Earlobes may be a bit intense. But I am looking at other pictures of him, and I do feel like in other pictures that his earlobes look a bit more intense. So maybe it's just an angle thing. Either way, I feel like this face sculpt is dead on. Now, they went with this, like, kind of battle wound here. We'll obviously get to that when we talk about details and such, but, you know, I don't know. Is that how you want him? You know, I feel like you get the option there. You have the beat-up face or the regular face, but you don't need to choose for me. That's my personal opinion. All right, let's talk about the soft goods and detailing. So, the head, we got so much paint here. We got that like, thumb-flecked paint throughout the face. It gives it a nice, realistic look. Like, all, like, the kind of pore texture and everything is sculpted in. Like, there's, like, you know, like, his neck, it's, like, a rougher skin. You know, this isn't a person that puts lotion on his skin 3 or 4 times a day. You know what I mean? The hair is all sculpted beautifully and painted well, fades in. You know, he should give a shout-out to his barber once in a while, because he's doing all right there, Mac. And, you know, the wound is done well enough. I'm not sure if I think that's the way they should have gone or not. Lips are painted great. Eyes are painted well. You know, it's got the nice sheen on them and such. Looks really good. Then we have this kind of like almost elastic material for a shirt underneath, which is actually fine. The stitching looks a little disproportionate. Like, these look like really big stitches here, but it doesn't really bother me. The vest is almost like, I almost feel like they should have gone with a stiffer material. Maybe they were trying to allow for some articulation. But there is tons of kind of work done to it. There's all sorts of stitching. We have the paint of the skull kind of thrown on, which is accurate and good. Then we have the extra kind of ammunition rounds, and you molly it all up. I know how you guys are. And then you have the extra straps here, and the buckles are all real buckles, and they're added in and sewn around and so forth. And then we had like the little kind of studs and doodads and whatnot and all the stitching in the back. I think the vest looks fantastic overall. Touching it is a little off-putting because it feels like it should be a different material, but I think aesthetically it works to the nines. Paint and such down the arms, you even have arm hair kind of sculpted into the arms, all the musculature and such, all that works. Heavy shading on the hands, subtle shading on the arms, which I think is the right choice. I think that's definitely the right choice. And then we have the BDU style pants. These, I don't feel like, are as effective as the rest of the figure overall. I think that this is where a little bit of suspension of disbelief is required, because this doesn't sit naturally. This is one of the big complaints I have with Hot Toys and 1/6 scale figures and soft goods in general, is that in order to get these pants to look like, if he was really wearing these, the weight of the pants would kind of constantly pull down and then bunch up here around the boot. But because they're not real pants and they don't have the same weight, they end up sitting all kind of fluffy throughout. And it's a little bit of a turnoff to me. Not the biggest deal in the world, but it's something that sticks out to me personally. The stitching is all accurate, though. Like, even that, like, if you ever wore a pair of BDUs, it's all stitched up like that and reinforced in that area. So it all works in that regard, stitching down the side for the zipper and so forth. But it's just how the weight distributes. You know, the stitching doesn't even really turn me off. Like, it looks smaller to me here than, say, this stitching does in the sleeve, but it's just the way the weight distributes. And then we have the boots, which are all sculpted and painted, mostly with just kind of some dry brushing stuff going on, but they are really well sculpted. You know, really, really well sculpted. You know, the sole, all the different material between, like, the structural elements and then the part to give your foot a little bit more flex, all the wrinkles and such, the laces, how the laces are woven throughout the boot, all of that stuff works extremely well. And then there is the back of the figure. Articulation-wise, I think it's a double ball peg from the neck into the head, and then nothing from the neck into the body, which I think is a bummer and a missed opportunity since we have the high collar here. You could have hidden all the joint underneath there and gotten them a little bit more of a downward look. As it works right now, you get a good up on him, but really, not much of a down at all, and this is a character where I feel like he needs to be looking down at you, probably because he just knocks you on your backside. And then the swivel works fine as well, so it's really just that one complaint there. Moving forward, we have a disc hinge shoulder coming into a ball peg inside the chest. Even with the soft goods, I don't think it's the soft goods actually that's preventing the range of motion. I think it's the sculpt of the shoulder in the torso. So you get up to there, and then even with the soft goods, you can get almost straight up and down, so no problems there. No bicep swivel. You do get it at the elbow. That is not the prettiest joint in the world, especially on a figure like this, but you get the swivel and you get 90 degrees. For the wrist swivel, it's the same type of thing. It's a ball hinge here going into the hand and into the forearm. So it swivels at both ends so you can get the swivel in, out, and up, down. You just rotate the hand around and that'll get you what you want. I feel like it's a double ball peg from the upper torso into the abdomen and then a single from the abdomen into the pelvis. But because of the vest, you don't really get a whole lot out of it. Although I don't think you would use it for a pose anyway with this type of a figure. Something I've kind of come to learn. But it is there, and you most importantly get the swivel, which is what most people I think would ultimately need and use. Articulation is the same for the other side. For the hips, we have T-jointed ball pegs rather. Great range of motion there. You know, even with the soft goods, no issues. You get a thigh around the ball peg, so no problems there. You got a double jointed knee that works like a champ, getting you almost the full range. And then moving down, you have this part of the boot, which is like a soft cover over top, and then you have a double ball peg from the boot into the foot. Now, you really have to pose this to hide the joint. There's a lot of excess space there. It's not a problem once you get it set up, and it gives you a little bit of leeway to get a pose, but you're gonna have to constantly cover down on that joint. I think it's ultimately worth the investment, like the price of admission, so to speak. Like I think it's worth the buy-in because you can get some great range, ankle tilt up to there, down to there, and a great rocker. So you can do a lot with the feet, which is one of my complaints of Hot Toys, is that a lot of times you can't do much with the feet. That's not true here. You just got to cover down and watch that joint so you don't lose the kind of the fluidity of sculpt. But I think you can do it without an issue. We're going to see in some poses here shortly. But yeah, I think that overall it works fairly well. Little strange cut joints here. Little limited for no reason kind of articulation and for the downward look. And then the waist is not the greatest, but I think it's ultimately fine. So overall, yeah. You know, one thing I will say that I can't stand about this company is, and I become a fan, don't get me wrong, is that like when it comes packaged, there's these like plastic wraps around the feet and it's like hard to get off. And like I have to cut it off with a knife. Like that's how this happened.
God, I wish they wouldn't wrap this up so tight.
Coming away as fast and aggressively as you can.
Don't hold that knife with the blade towards you.
Quiet you.
Oh, bleeding. Bleeding.
Final thoughts wise, just to give you an idea real quick, like with the feet, you know, like that's a pose you're able to get with this guy that I'm not able to get with a lot of other Hot Toys. And it's because of the way that they sculpted the boots. I do have to watch those joints and cover down on them and make sure that it works. But it's this one right here that because of the cut and because of how I cover down, I'm able to get this pose. That's how I make that work. And I think ultimately it's worth the cost of doing business. So yeah, let's talk about the negatives though. I really would have liked some downward movement in a hinge in the neck. I think it would have been easy to put in. I'm not sure why they didn't. The cut joints on the elbows really don't bother me, but I know they bother some, so I think it's worth mentioning. The pants are an issue. That's where I feel like the biggest suspension of disbelief is hurt. It's in how the pants end up looking on the figure. But they don't get in the range of articulation at all, so that's a nice thing. And honestly, like, am I being too greedy? I don't feel like I'm being too greedy. I feel like we should have got more guns. Like, I would have liked, like, some, like, Glock-type guns. You know, I would have liked, like just some variety. I mean, I know we got a machine gun and, you know, this Gatling gun or minigun or whatever. But, like, I would have liked some more pistols. I think I really would have liked some more pistols and been able to arm them up a little bit. You know, throwing some extra holsters and stuff on his thighs, or you know, I don't know. That to me, that's a thing. I'm not sure if you guys feel the same way, but I feel like you could have, you know, made him a little bit more able to quickly punish, let's say. Plenty of good, though. The accessories that you do get are great. The articulation works fairly well across the board with a few little hiccups here and there, but for the most part, more articulated than most Hot Toys, in my opinion. The soft goods are done fairly well, with the exception of some of the seams in the shirt looking a little too large and the pants not really carrying the weight that they should. The face sculpt is beautiful. The paint, where it is applied everywhere on this figure, is top shelf. Well, I should also mention that this scope is removable. You can slide it all the way off and on. I didn't mention that. That's a thing. Yeah, I think it's great. It's a strong recommend for me if you're into the character, into the series, or into the brand. I think you'll be happy. Just a couple little bumps along the road, but hey, nothing's perfect. Thanks for listening. Thanks for watching. Until next time, take care.